When starting a new acne treatment, things can sometimes worsen before they get better. This is known as acne purging. Now, this initial purge doesn't happen for everyone, but for the 20 to 25% of people who start a new medical grade acne treatment and are experiencing skin purging or retinization, I wanted to make this video answering four of the most common questions in regards to skin purging, going over what exactly is going on, how does purging happen, how to tell if it's skin purging or irritation, and finally, what you could do to reduce it. You don't want to miss this. Stay tuned till the end. Hi guys, you see an Arsenal Media Pharmacist here on YouTube, where I help you guys make better and more informed decisions about your health and wellness. So if that's something you're into, be sure to smash that like button below now. Also, while you're at it, hit that subscribe button too, as well as the notification bell right next to it to stay up to date with new weekly health and wellness videos. So without further ado, let's get straight into it. I get a ton of questions from you guys about this topic from my Differin video I made on what you should know before trying out Differin. Before I get into what it is and how to use it, let's look at five things you should know of first. And the video itself did so well, which I'm very thankful to you guys for leaving such great feedback and watching the video. I wanted to make this as a follow-up to that video. So if you haven't watched it yet, I'll leave the link at the upper right-hand corner. So definitely go check that out after this video. The first question I get asked is, what is going on during the purge? Acne purging or skin purging is when a person's acne condition seems to get worse when they begin an effective topical treatment. To break the news to you guys, your clogged pores may turn into active pimples, your small pimples may turn into larger pimples or can even form pustules, and you may even start to think about giving up the product altogether.
No! No!
This is because the active ingredients in acne treatments, in this video I'm going to use Differin as an example, they have several side effects that can initially cause the acne to get worse before producing significant results. How does skin purging or retinization happen? Your new products you're using essentially causes the skin's upper layers to shed off while pushing all the gunk, sebum, and bacteria in your skin out to the outer surfaces. The pimples and cysts that would otherwise have come to the surface in the future weeks and months start to come out quicker and seemingly all at once.
You can talk?
That's right, and we're gonna raise some hair.
This then triggers an immune response in your skin, essentially an overreaction of the body to send help to the skin, causing an increase in inflammation, which intensifies the new and existing breakouts. Which skincare ingredients cause purging the most? The most common offenders are retinoids. These include the retinoid family, so something like Differin or adapalene is a very popular one to cause them. Retinols, tretinoin, and even exfoliating acids like your AHAs and BHAs can cause them too, and in some cases, benzoyl peroxide as well. With our example with Differin, you should see some sort of purging within the first or second week and gradually subsides around 28-day mark. However, this will depend on how fast your skin cycle turnarounds are, so don't be alarmed if it takes up to 6 to 8 weeks. In the second week or so, your skin may become irritated, causing dryness, scaling, redness, and even burning. This usually will end up getting cleared out on its own once all the blockages lurking beneath the surface have been cleared out and your skin starts off new again. So in the meantime, keep moisturizing and wear an SPF sunscreen during the daytime until the purge is over. Talk to your dermatologist if your purge has lasted longer than 6 weeks and no improvement has been seen. I know it can be very tempting to stop using the retinoid or the exfoliating acid altogether, but try to resist discontinuing, especially if you want to see the full results. The third question I always get asked is, what's the difference between skin purging and just flat out irritation? Unlike normal pimples, acne that results from a purge will tend to grow and heal faster. This different life cycle indicates that your skin is currently cleansing itself. Also, the breakouts you'll have are likely to be in areas you normally have clogged pores or blemishes. However, if you start to break out or experience inflammation, redness in an area that you're usually completely clear of, this could indicate irritation rather than purging. Also, if any symptoms like breakouts or other sensitivities seem to be getting worse over time, this could also be an indicator that the product is not right for you. And the fourth question I always get asked is, what can I do to minimize the effects of purging or essentially speed it up? And I get it. 4 to 6 weeks may sound like a long time to wait for the skin of your dreams, but I have three tips here I want to share. The number one tip I can give you guys is don't pick any of the acne. It's going to be incredibly tempting, and there's two reasons for this. Number one, it'll only extend the purge period, and two, it may lead to permanent scarring. The second tip I have is don't use products that will excessively dry it out either. Many spot treatments you could be using, like exfoliants like benzoyl or salicylic acid, keep them far, far away from purging skin. It's already in the midst of cell turnover, and extra stimulation will probably only make things worse. Unless, of course, you are prescribed to do so in the case of epiduo. And lastly, check your cosmetics. Make sure that your makeup and sunscreen are clearly labeled oil-free and or non-comedogenic to ensure that they do not contribute to clogged pores. And to reduce the severity of a purge, it's best to slowly introduce a new product. To do so, start with a lower concentration or a smaller amount. I know for the different video I did, a lot of you guys asked me if I can add salicylic acid, benzoyl peroxide, lactic acid, glycolic acid, and it's like, guys, more active ingredients is not always better. The risk of chemical burning is real, and you should not add more products on your face than what the minimum amount of product is available to bring about the most effective results. And a dermatologist who can see your face in person can answer exactly how many products you will need. Differin already is a powerful retinoid, and it works when used correctly. But to really sum it up, you gotta think of purging as your way of cleansing the pipes. A lot of gunk can come up before things start to clean and clear. And I know it can be frustrating and disheartening, but it is a way to indicate that things will be getting much better in the coming weeks and months. It's just gonna require some patience, but it'll be worth the clear skin that's waiting for you just around the corner. I hope that this video was useful to you guys and that you learned something new. Like the video now if you did enjoy it, and subscribe to stay involved with all my other weekly health and wellness videos. Thanks for sticking to all the way to the end, and as always, I'll see you. Yes, you right there. I'll see you on the next one.